Are you kidding me? Calm down!
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
What you have just discovered there is my entire reaction to how the Ducks have played for the last 2 months. Welcome, everybody, to episode 21 of QuackCast. I am Matt. Please sign me up to be the head coach, Rosoff. Dear Lord. Pat Verbeek, our new GM, needs to start making moves. And the first move he needs to do is getting rid of the coach. You could trade Hampus Lindholm or Ricard Raquel later, though you'll get a good return from them depending on the team you trade them to, but the first move needs to be the coach, at least in my opinion. Say I'm crazy, say I'm wrong, the Ducks must fire Dallas Eakins.
Correct.
He's just not an NHL coach. Too stubborn with his lineups and terrible distribution of ice time. The effort has been pretty sporadic from the Ducks. I mean, the game against the Sharks was good effort, but I want to see that against stronger teams. And they did not show that against Chicago, even though they're not a stronger team, and they have 10 less wins than us or so on the season. But Nashville is a strong team. You guys put up an even amount of shots, and you played an even style of game, and Gibson was better, despite the fact that he gave up an early goal to Duchesne on the power play, and then they got a goal late in the second period. I can give Gibson a little credit there. He played a better game, but now, if for offense, if you're gonna watch your goalie play a good game, you gotta score some goals.
That is correct.
Now there were a few times where you were robbed, and I get that. But you guys gotta get past that and keep trying and actually score eventually. Sometimes you actually have to actually put the puck in the net, and you guys seem to be struggling with that. It's gotta change. Like I said on a few episodes last year, hey Ducks, if you want to sign me up, just give me a call. I'll come play. Maybe I'll score. Maybe I'll throw a little competitive spirit onto the team as well. Or maybe I'll just step out and get smoked on the ice. It's another thing to do as well.
Correcto!
So, as you saw in the first clip, the Hawks scored 6 quick ones, and mostly was the combination of Dylan Strome, Patrick Kane, and Alex DeBrincat. Somewhere sprinkled in there was Brandon Hagel and Ryan Carpenter as well. Jakob Silverberg, Trevor Zegras, and Adam Henrique would score our 3 goals against Marc-Andre Fleury. So I guess for the first time this season, the Ducks actually score on their overlord Fleury. He gets his 22nd win in 27 tries against us, absolutely absurd. Dylan Strome actually had a hat trick in this game on his birthday. Happy birthday, Dylan. Wish he would have done that against someone that was not named the Anaheim Ducks. And then we get to today. This game just ended a few minutes ago. Ducks lose 4-1. As I mentioned, Duchesne got the first goal. It was Philip Forsberg halfway through the second and the second goal. After relentless battling, Adam Henrique puts the puck past Saros. And the Ducks had chances. They even got a 2-minute you can't do that late in the penalty on Nashville late in the third. But of course, they kill it off. And Colton Sissons, who you may remember killed us in the playoffs a few years ago when we went to the third round. He would get the goal past Gibson, his sixth from Matt Benning and Tanner Janot. And then it would be Shane McLean. Hey, at least within this game on ESPN Plus, I'm just happy we didn't get the curse of Leia Hextall. We got someone else. I don't know who it was. If somebody wants to fill me in on that in the comments section below, please do. So, recapping the scores, 8-3, Ducks lose in Chicago. And then tonight in Nashville, the Ducks lose 4-1. Just absolutely terrible. This weekend, we are playing the New Jersey Devils. Now you're going to ask yourself, how the devil are we going to win that game if the Ducks are absolutely terrible at playing hockey? That's a good question, which we'll discuss in just a second. Either that last goal from Sissons was a perfect shot or John Gibson can't goalie. I don't know. I'm going to probably go with the good shot by Sissons, though I would have loved to have seen a little more effort on the attempt to save it. We play the New Jersey Devils. The Devils are having a devil of a time winning games this year, but they have some pretty solid players, and one of them is Jesper Bratt, who leads the team in goals with 19. He also has 36 assists for a total of 55 points. It's actually surprising that nobody on the Devils has scored 20 goals yet this season. Jack Hughes is the second leading scorer, on the New Jersey team. He also has 2 goals in his last 5, along with 5 assists and 7 points in each of his last 5 contests. Jack Hughes, you may remember, was the first overall pick in the draft a few years ago. And we've talked about his brother on the show before, Quinn Hughes, the defenseman of the Vancouver Canucks. So Jack Hughes, overall this season, second in goals is 17, so 2 behind Jesper, 26 assists and 43 points. Very solid player indeed. I would also then say keep your eye on Damon Severson, a defenseman, who's 3rd in assists on the Devils. He has 25. And let's also keep our eyes out for Dawson Mercer. He has, in his first season, he has 20 assists to go along with 14 goals. So pretty solid rookie year for Dawson. And one more guy that I think we should watch for is Yegor Sharangovich. He has 14 goals and 16 assists for 30 points this year. This is his second season in the league, and he needs 3 more goals to hit his career high. The other guy I want you to keep your eye on the Devils is Ryan Graves, number 33, the defenseman. A couple years ago, he had one of the best plus-minus ratings ever that I've ever seen. He had a plus 40 with the Colorado Avalanche in 2019-20. I believe he was paired with Cale Makar at that time, or maybe Sam Girard. But in his career, he's a plus 56, so he's very good on the blue line. Keep your eye on Ryan Graves, the long-haired defenseman wearing number 33. The Ducks, Troy Terry, 28 goals still, leads the team. Adam Henrique, a center, he may get traded at the deadline, scored in the lone goal for the Ducks against the Predators. He now has 13 on the season. That's good enough for 5th place. And let's also watch for Ricard Raquel, who has 16 goals on the season, which ties him for 2nd place with Zegras. And also, let's keep an eye out for, how about Vinny Lattery? 5 goals on the season, but he has had some pretty good moments in the past, so let's keep our eye out for those guys. Oh yeah, the injuries. Isaac Lundestrom, Jakob Silfverberg, and Ryan Getzlaf all on injured reserve with various injuries. Ouch. Danny O'Regan, Buddy Robinson, and the aforementioned Vinny Lattery were recalled to take their place. We also claimed Andre Schuster, a Ducks legend, coming back for round 2 with us. He wears number 92. He's a huge defenseman, so we'll see a little bit more of him. He's not really a big impact player. He's just known for his size. Let's look at the Islanders game on Sunday. The Isles obviously shut us out in our last game, 4-0, but in a reverse go against the Devils back in October, we shut them out by the same mentioned score.
Interesting.
Brock Nelson is the leading goal scorer for the New York Islanders with 22. He has 10 assists for 32 points. He was pretty impactful in the game in terms of making plays for his teammates. Noah Dobson scored in the game versus the Ducks last time. He has 2 goals in his last 5 games. 5 points in his last five games, so a point per game in that stretch. And Jean-Gabriel Pageau, who scored in the Islanders shutout today versus Columbus, he has 4 assists in his last five, so let's keep your eye on those guys. Matthew Barzal, I believe, is back from injury. He leads the team in assists with 25 assists. Very good puck handler. Keep your eye on that guy. Stolarz is starting likely in one of these two games because back-to-backs. I think he's going to get the Islanders. Actually, you know what? I'm going to say that he goes against the Devils because what I've seen is that when it's West and East Coast teams, they usually play the other goalie in the second meeting. So, for example, they played Ilya Sorokin last time for the Islanders. They may go Semyon Varlamov, though I'm likely wrong about that. I would like to see Stolarz go against the Devils, or at least in one of these two games. We'll see how it goes. I'm going to say Stolarz and then Gibson. So, for the predictions, the Devils game, for as not faithful as very slandering as I have been of the Ducks, I am going to pick the Ducks to beat the Devils because we usually have had the better of the Devils in our past matchups. The Devils can score goals because of the talent they have, but I think that the Ducks are going to somehow manage to win a game here with a good effort, and it's going to be by a score of 4-3 in regulation. And the Islanders game, if we're rolling with Sorokin again for the Islanders, I expect Sorokin to shut us out for the second time in about a month, and his team is going to shut us out by a score of 6-0. Okay, everybody, that's it for predictions, and that will wrap up this rather rant-infested and overly dramatic iteration of a QuackCast episode. What did you think of it? Please put your comments down below. And remember to like this video, if you somehow did, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell to be notified when new content is posted. Remember, have a good night. Remember, stay safe. Go Ducks. And let's get a win. Oh, and one more thing. The MLB lockout is over, and Angels fan Matt will be back with another video for y'all very soon. So stay tuned for that. Go Ducks.